Ready? Here we go. I'm letting him in.
Go, Sheriff.
Boom. Everybody's popping in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Look at that. They're connecting. We can't see them yet, but they'll be here soon.
All right.
You are a pretty handsome guy, Sheriff. Sean, you're a handsome dude.
Hello, Alyssa.
Hi, how are you?
Good. How are you doing?
Good. Nervous, but good.
No need to be nervous. No need to be nervous. And hello, Julia.
Hi, Julia.
Hello.
Hello, Alyssa, Julia.
I still can't see Rick or Michelle or Galaxy S10. But so you guys might want to turn on your cameras. But I'll get things started here because I know Sean is in a bit of a crunch. Obviously, welcome. This is awesome. My name is Larry McFeelie, and I work at KUPD, and I host the midday shift on the radio station. I'm also the program director, and these guys are in Grey Daze, and it's hard to know who's on what corner on which screen, but Sean Dowdell, also got Mace Windu, or Mace Byers, whatever you want to call him, and Kristen Davis. And Angelo over there in the corner, he's from the record label and he's just overseeing because he wants to make sure that we don't do anything bad.
I'm an assistant today.
And then of course you got Mark Randall, who's also from KUPD, and he is the guy that helped put a lot of this together. First off, congratulations. This has been quite the long road. You guys have been going along here for a while, and the album was supposed to come out in March, and obviously COVID hit, and here we are finally tomorrow. Amends will be released. There's Rick. I see Rick now. Finally, Amends will be released. So congratulations. How's that feel?
Feels great, man. 2.5 years of hard work. So we finally, I think, can see the finish line tomorrow. And of course, we still have lots of work to do with pushing the record. But I think the three of us feel a sense of release and a sense that we actually were able to pull it off and get it to where it needed to be. And thank you guys for supporting us so much. You guys have been so influential and instrumental in making this a success. So thank you.
Absolutely.
Yeah, thank you.
Happy to do it. Very happy to do it for sure. I wrote out a bunch of questions, but I know we're trying to zip through here kind of quickly. So maybe we'll start with some of the listener questions and just going left to right. Let's start off with Alyssa. What do you got for the boys today?
All right. My question's kind of silly, but I'm a big fan of local pizza restaurants and stuff like that. So I wanted to know if you guys had a favorite place that you like to go that maybe I wouldn't have heard of.
I'm a food guy, so I'll jump right on that.
Yeah, he's a foodie.
There's a place called Old Chicago in Gilbert. It used to be in Mesa. It's probably my favorite pizza place in Arizona. And then there's a place on the west side in Glendale called Pizza by Napoli. It does old school, thick crust, kind of Chicago style pizza. So those are my two favorites.
Oh, that's right.
I'm from Jersey, so there's nothing around here that floats my boat at all.
Wow. Slamming the Arizona pizza.
I got Benicia's. That's one of my favorites. And then there's Freak Brothers at the Churchill down here in downtown where I live. So that's another go-to place I go.
Kristen, we're talking about pizza. Pizza.
Yeah, I know. Those are different Freak Brothers that you're thinking of.
You need to come back when your mustache is full grown again. Because I don't know who you are.
All of a sudden, Kristen's going to start telling you about his favorite Greek food.
I'll take all of it.
Julia, what do you got for the boys today?
Let me unmute my. So my question is more band related. I want to know what your plans are for 2021 as far as touring. Are you guys going to tour?
Kristen, you want to handle that?
Sure. So no plans to tour. Obviously, there's a big piece of the band missing that we would need in order to do that. So I think we're not opposed to doing something live if it made sense and had the right feel, but everything we do has to be Chester-centric and him first.
Right.
So it has to make sense to not be disrespectful to him.
Right.
And we just haven't figured out what that would look like or how we'd do that yet. But we're open to it. There's nothing. I think we're waiting for the demand to be there before we cross that bridge.
Okay. And that was kind of what I was curious about, because I knew obviously this is Chester centric. So we were kind of curious about that whole thing. And I like your shirt, by the way. I have the same one.
We obviously would love to play this music. We love it. We love listening to it. But it's just, how do you do that without,
right,
you know, the focal point being there? So it's just, we haven't figured out how to do it right yet.
We do have some ideas, and I'm fairly sure in the next 6 months we'll have something to where we have to do something, because we're getting a lot of people asking us to do this. So, but like Kristen said, we need to make sure it's done respectfully and doesn't be easy. We don't want to have this weird, you know, deal hologram or whatever. No disrespect to them. I shouldn't even have said it that way. We just want to make sure that whatever we do, it comes off not cheesy.
Sure.
And it's funny, because I was actually going to bring up something about that a lot of people don't know is, you know, last year you guys were here at the KUPD studios when you brought down the music and you were playing it, and we were all sitting in my office and having this great discussion, and we were like, yeah, this is awesome. We're going to play a bunch of this stuff. And hey, maybe you should play U-Fest next year. And we were all excited about that and thinking about the different possibilities. And then COVID happened, and now we're kind of sitting here again going, well, maybe you could play U-Fest next year in 2021.
Yeah.
Something like that would be cool if we had like a bunch of different guests come each sing a song, but logistically that's just a nightmare. But that would be one of the things we might consider.
Awesome. Tribute fashion.
Well, moving along, Michelle, what do you got for us today? Uh-oh, can't hear you. Got to turn Michelle on the audio. No, audio not working.
Is she no. Just
no.
You might be able to unmute her, Larry.
Or she's nervous. Maybe she doesn't want to be unmuted. She doesn't want to be unmuted. She doesn't want to be unmuted. How about let's go down to Rick. Rick, what do you got for the boys? Rick, are you there? Can you hear me? He looks like he's
Yeah, I can hear you.
No. Okay. You got a question for the guys today?
I do. I actually, I've been a fan of the band since it was SD and his friend.
Is that Rick Collins?
I've known Sean for many, many years. He wasn't playing the drums at this time. So my question to Sean is, like, what did you have to do to get yourself back behind that kid? I mean, I wasn't even sure you were going to play.
So it's so good to see Rick Collins. I've known that guy for a long time. I haven't seen him in years, but he used to be around the band.
I love you, brother.
And so good to see your face, Rick. You know, I've been semi-active in the music industry still. I mean, Chester and I played in some little side projects. Kristen and I played a couple times in some little stuff. And so I've still maintained active on the drums. I have a drum set at my house. Once Chester and I started talking about putting the band back together, I got on it pretty seriously. I started rehearsing about 2 hours a day and getting my chops up, because the last thing I wanted to do was let these guys down when we went into the studio. To not be able to pull this stuff off. And you know, my chops are up, dude. I could throw down. So I'm doing just.
You got chops, baby. You got chops.
Yeah, you did a good job, man. Everything that I've heard is awesome.
Thank you.
Another thing I wanted to mention, and maybe you guys have or have not done this already, those of you that are listeners of the radio station that enjoy Grey Daze, when you get the new album Amends, go back and forth. You know, most of the Grey Daze stuff is available on YouTube, the older material. Go back and forth and listen to some of those old tracks, and then listen to what they've done now, and you'll really get a feel as to how much work they put into this album. It's pretty incredible when you go back and forth between the tracks. It's pretty awesome. So congrats again on that. Sounds great.
Thank you.
Absolutely. And Mr. Galaxy S10, what do you got for us today, sir?
By the way, my name is Steven. I don't know why I did that, but I just want to know what was it like being with Chester Bennington?
Well, we didn't look at him like he was Chester Bennington. That's the first thing. He was our buddy.
That's our friend. Yeah, our buddy.
We talked as much shit to him as we did to each other. So
he was
just one of the guys. So we didn't really look at, I know it's hard for you probably to understand, but it wasn't like that for us. He was our friend. We called him when we wanted to go play basketball. We would go on trips to Mexico. We would go running together. It was not a, hey, I'm going to call Chester from Linkin Park. I never once thought about that like that.
Yeah, I think, like, for me, it's like I always tell people I've never met Chester from Linkin Park, because I just know Chester, the guy I went to high school with. You know what I mean? He didn't change at all. And I think that's one of the things that we all appreciate so much about him, was he could have become Chester from Linkin Park and this bigger than life person around us. And he never acted that way even once around any of us. And it was that to me is one of the things I admire most about him, is all the success that he had never changed who he was as a person. And that's, I think, difficult to do for a lot of people. So big props to him for maintaining who he was even after his success.
It's like everything changed around him, but him, you know, the whole world just changed around him. But He was one of the guys
that would even, like, he'd be trying to pick up gear off a stage, and, you know, in our business, he'd be trying to sell a t-shirt off the rack. He was just a normal guy. He was a lot more normal than some of his fans, and he was a lot more normal than some of his fans, you know?
Yeah. Sean, you've been doing so many interviews recently. I mean, I've seen so many interviews on YouTube and Instagram, and some of them have butchered your name, calling you Sean Dowdle. I've heard some really funny, like, weird stories in some of these interviews where they're telling a story and you're like, I don't even know what you're talking about. I'm not sure I've ever even heard that story. If Chester were here with us and he were still in Grey Daze doing these, do you think he would be like proud of you, or do you think he would kind of push you aside and be like, let me show you how it's done, kid?
No, he would not be doing that. He would probably tell Mace to shut up, and then
absolutely
we would Chester and I did a lot of interviews together even when he was in Linkin Park. So that's the cool thing about understanding him as a human being, is we are business partners for so long and friends for so long. We literally did 100 interviews over the last 20 years together, not being in a band. So I think I'm pretty well versed in giving interviews and not avoiding questions, being pretty direct and being honest. And I think Chester, I learned a lot from him early on, for sure, on how to give an interview, but I don't think he'd be pushing me aside. I think we'd be, you know, high-fiving each other, laughing about, we can't believe that this is, we're doing this at this age.
I'd like to think some balls would get busted a little bit, though.
Oh, without a doubt.
For sure. And recently, as of recent, you don't have to use any names or anything, but what would you say is probably the worst question that you've been asked recently?
Oh, man.
Was it the interview with Larry McFeelie when he asked you about the worst question that you've ever been asked?
No. One of the interviewers asked me if I had sex with any of the same people Chester did. I was like, why did you ask that?
And what was the answer when you said, why would you ask that?
You either.
That's nice. I'll answer that.
I'm sure you will, Mace. Thumbs up.
That's funny.
All you can say. Well, we have a couple of tracks off of the album I wanted to play for you guys, or share with you guys, that you haven't heard yet that are unreleased. And one of them is called The Syndrome. And I don't know if you want to, like, set this up while I'm kind of, like, getting the audio ready on my side. Let them know about it.
Sure. So The Syndrome was originally called The Down Syndrome, and we decided to change the name just due to political correctness. We didn't want anyone to think we were singing about, you know, a disease or a mental illness. So we just, and that's not what it means. The name, The Down Syndrome, was specifically talking about depression. So we just changed it from The Down Syndrome to The Syndrome. Cool little known fact is there's a really awesome acoustic version of one that we recorded back on just a piano and a couple of guitars that has not seen the light of day in a long time. And then this version, it was really cool. I think it was one of the first versions that Kristen actually got to sit in with the band and write with us guitar parts. It's one of my favorite tracks on the record. I just love how hard it hits. And then I got to have my son Karsten play on the song drums as well. So
nice.
One of my favorite tracks, and I just love the vocal line where Chester says, "Are you happy?" It's just a poignant.
That's always been my favorite line, man. Like, since 20 years ago, I'd wait for him to sing that line. It's just so huge. It's so quiet, but so huge.
Awesome. Well, let's see if I can share this out to you guys right now, and definitely let me know if you're not hearing the audio.
We'll let you know if we're happy.
Is this on the air, Larry, or are we just?
No, just us. We'll be right back.
people come around, people let you down. Anywhere you go, anyone you see, it's real.
Song's just missing one thing, man.
What's that? More cowbell?
I don't.
Well, that's Sean's fault. Sean, more cowbell.
I got it at my house a year ago and never picked it up. So,
great tune. Notice, I mean,
there's no production credits for Mace on the record for a reason.
That's why there was very little cowbell. Yeah. Great tune.
In fact, it's all cowbell, so.
Good. Yeah, you guys did a hell of a job, man. I got to hand it to you. I mean, it's a great album. Again, to those that don't know, it's coming out tomorrow, I'm super stoked. I mean, I feel like we've been waiting a lifetime to hear this stuff and
thank you, Larry.
The light that it should be heard in. You know, I learned something on TV the other day, and this is kind of a bummer in the world that we're living in right now, but I found it really interesting and I thought I would share it on the call. But group singing, apparently, you know, like when you go to the baseball game and everybody's singing, take me out to the ball, like group singing actually reduces stress. And when we sing together, apparently our brainwaves synchronize, and the other people that we're, you know, we sync with the other people that we're singing along with, and oxytocin is released and it makes you feel good. And here we are in this age where we can't get together and we can't sing together.
Let's do it right now. What are we singing?
Are you telling me that my brain releases Oxycontin when I sing?
Yes, your brain releases Oxycontin when you sing.
I just learned something.
So start singing, man, because we're ready to get high.
It's oxytocin, not Oxycontin. I think there's a slight difference there.
Should I play another track and we can sing along to that?
Yeah, I mean, and we could also take more questions from the winners if you'd like.
Are you happy? I'm ready.
Well, I know that we're a little crunched for time, so I just want to make sure if we go back through again. Michelle, is there anything that you wanted to type in as far as in the chat window for a question? I know that your mic isn't working, so feel free. If you want to type something into the chat window, you can still ask a question that way. Does anybody else have a secondary question that they wanted to follow up with? If not, we'll throw on another tune.
Private chatted Michelle. Michelle's an old friend of ours, so she said she didn't have any questions, I don't think.
No questions. Please.
He moved to Europe.
Well, let's, there you go. Well, let's throw on another tune. And how do you pronounce? Is it Moray or Morai?
Moray Sky.
So another track
so
off of the album.
Track, that Chester and I wrote the lyrics to while we were sitting on the beach in Mexico, Rocky Point, Mexico. And there was just a really cool sunset. And the name comes from an old silkscreen pattern. I used to do silkscreen t-shirts. I said, hey, that looks like a Moray silkscreen pattern. And Chester goes, oh, it's a Moray Sky. And we literally sat on the back of my friend Henry's truck and we wrote out the lyrics to Moray Sky together and then brought it to band practice the following week and actually wrote the song. This is probably, I don't know, this might be Kristen's favorite song on the record or close to it. I know I love the guitar energy on this whole song and the lyrical content. Listening to it now versus when we wrote it, it's kind of taken on a whole new, deeper meaning. And it feels like an apology from beyond, from Chester.
Cool.
Yeah, like lyrically, this one, I think, is the one that I think we shed the most tears over when we were recording it and through the process. And it was, you know, it's basically, to me, the way I view it now, obviously it wasn't that way when he wrote it, but this is an apology for what he had done. And we talked about it on some other interviews, but like, we know he would have regretted it the second it happened. And this is, to us, him saying sorry.
Oh, it's interesting too for me.
I'm sorry, I wasn't trying to cover up what you were saying there, Mace. If you wanna finish, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Couldn't have done that, bit, Larry.
Sorry.
You made Sean say, just so you know. The moment has passed. Move along. Let's hear it.
Okay. All right. Here we go.
I dreamt of yesterday.
What do you think, Dave?
Pretty awesome.
Hey, Larry.
Pretty awesome.
I'd like to talk about something real quick. This is a first. So, Soul Song and Maurice Sky, we had live strings, actually. And this was unique for me. A very talented, cool human, Heidi Gadd, played cello. And she's Matt. We're basically mirroring my bass. And
hey, man.
That is cello. And it's hey, very
I hate like, to I have to jump on another interview.
Oh, just thank me. You. We had enough
of you. You guys stay and still talk. This is awesome. I just have to jump on something for Canada. I absolutely appreciate everything that 98 KUPD has done for this band and for us personally, and just want to say thank you on behalf of Mace, Kristen, and myself, to you, Larry, and to you, Mark Randall. You guys have been fucking awesome. Thank you so much.
You bet. Anytime.
How about tomorrow? Buddy.
Take care.
Do it again. You bet. Over and over again.
Talk to you later, Sean.
All right. Have a good one, Sean. All right. So there you go. You know, I don't know if anybody else has any other questions for the remaining members of the band, Kristen, or Mace Windu. And actually, you know, for those that got on the call a little bit later, Mace, why don't you tell them, like, what happened to you, dude? I mean, this just blew me away. I had no idea what was going on right now.
I got hit by a truck on my Harley it's a month now. So I broke 10 ribs. I have half metal right now. My collarbone is metal. I punctured both lungs. My left leg, I shattered the top of the tibia. So basically, I'm in a recliner right now, if you're looking at me.
Heading out on tour tomorrow.
Yeah, I'm out tomorrow, man, with a walker.
Bionic
me. I'll be up and running in a couple months, walking-wise, but I'm just blessed and happy. I can still play, and, you know, I got my good looks. I can, yeah, I'll be walking in a few months.
I'm sure that we know you're what?
I'm the only guy that can actually say, like, a couple times I sent letter when I was emailing the label in the middle of all this, I was like, Mace, I got hit by a truck, Myers. Because how many people can say they actually got hit by a truck?
Yeah.
And even I couldn't make the B12 video I was supposed to be in. But because I was laying in a hospital bed because I got hit.
Oh.
So that's why you only see a bass. And I remember 3 a.m. with our videographer editing those parts, making sure, I like that one. It kind of looks like I'd play that one.
Yeah. Yeah. So I guess we know what you're up to during this whole state shutdown, more or less. But
Chris, how to walk, man, therapy.
Yeah, learning how to walk again. But Kristen, what has been taking up the majority of your time while you're sitting around at home?
I work from home, so I just work more. So I just literally just go into my office and sit here. I'll show you. I just wear sweatpants every day. I got my sweatpants on.
Leopard print, nice.
I sit in my office and I work. And
you do better than me because I literally have no pants on right now. I just have a rope on the chair. So
well, you didn't need to know that
today, so I made a concession. But yeah, just working too much. And a lot of people don't know this, but Larry actually introduced me to my wife 20 years ago. So I'm hanging out with Geneva all the time, and Larry and I are personal friends on and off the air. So
now wait a sec. You just said wife.
Yeah.
I call her that because it's ridiculous for us to be together for 20 years without being married. But right. We actually almost got married in Vegas in February.
What?
And let's plan it a little more so it's not spur of the moment. Now we're like, we should have done it because who knows when we'll be able to go back. But
that's true. But I do hope to be there if you guys are going to get married, for sure.
We want to. Well, I was going to do like a quick Vegas thing and then do a party thing. So it was kind of spur of the moment, but it was like not like spur of the moment while we're there, but like a day before we left, we're like, let's do it. And then we're like, well, I need to lose 20 pounds and get some new hats. So,
hey, Larry, get ordained and then you can marry them.
Ooh.
Exactly. You probably
are a bad idea. I don't know if Kristen would want me doing that, though.
Sure.
But you know what, Kristen? I could do it. I could get ordained and then wear the blue tuxedo and I could marry you guys as Larry Oakey and sing a few songs afterwards.
There's you can hire a little person, Gene Simmons, that we were thinking about using in Vegas. But
there you go.
Something ridiculous. It'd be fun.
Did he at least have a long tongue?
Yeah, he did. Okay. I don't know if it was really his or not, but it's he's got one.
Well, yeah. here's another question, and this kind of goes out to everybody. Right now on the radio station, we're doing this thing with Toyota where we're offering an excellent adventure, which is basically giving you guys $3,000 to take your own excellent adventure with. And I was really lucky earlier in the year. I got to take this great camping trip. Mark went with me. We were out in the snow in the middle of Forest Lakes, Arizona. It was awesome. And like we had checked our email a few times, you know, while we were out there, we'd hiked out of the campsite that we were in, checked our email and started seeing all this weird stuff about shelter in place and all this kind of weird stuff. So it was like right in that period that all that kind of stuff happened. If you had $3,000 to take a little trip, what would be your idea of an excellent adventure right now? And we'll start with Mace.
Oh, well, it'd have to not involve walking or running or jumping or doing anything
physically. Well, it could just be a full-blown, you spend $3,000 on alcohol.
Mace is sober.
I'm sober. So that's not going to happen.
Well, that doesn't work either then, does it?
Okay. I'm going to Japan and just getting wheeled around in all the arcades and everything. I haven't been to Japan yet. So all this, you know, kind of like the game areas and, you know, all the kind of sci-fi stuff they got going on with robots and all that. I kind of want to hit Japan. So I go to Japan.
Nice.
I get in a wheelchair and get wheeled around in Japan.
Excellent. Kristen, what about you? What would you do with $3,000 on an adventure right now? You could do anything.
I'd rent a yacht. I'd go sit on the water somewhere, and I'd have to get one with some extra jet skis and things on it, and I'd go sit out in the bay somewhere. Like Geneva and I went to Florida last year, and we rented we stayed on a sailboat out, and they just docked it out in the ocean, and we stayed on it. And I fell in love with being out there on the water. It was right by the sandbar, so you could like kayak over and stand in the middle of the ocean, and they had like, you could have beers there and everything. So it was awesome. That's what I would do for sure.
And like, you didn't get seasick at all? Like, you know, you're sleeping in the middle of the night.
It was hard for me to sleep because I just thought about this thing sinking the whole time, but, which is probably my mental illness, but it was super fun. Like after I, you know, finally got used to the motion of the ocean and swaying around, it was fine, but it had a hammock on it and we did a bunch of super fun stuff. So I love that. I miss doing summery stuff while we're all stuck inside, you know?
Yeah. Alyssa, what about you? What would be your excellent adventure right now?
That's really tough. I've always wanted to go to Tokyo Disney. So that'd probably be my excellent adventure if it, you know, opens again and everything's normal.
Yeah.
The coolest places I've ever been, for sure. I love it there.
Yeah.
Tokyo?
Tokyo Disney.
I ate ramen noodles in the Tokyo airport at Bob's Big Boy. It was the most surreal moment of my life.
At Bob's Big Boy, they had a noodles?
Yeah, there's a big, giant, you know, the Bob's Big Boy statue where he's holding the
burger?
You go up the escalator and there's like a big one in there, and I ordered noodles there. It was super surreal. It was fun.
Huh.
That's awesome. And you brought it back around to food. So
he's right.
What about you, Julia?
I'd go to Scotland.
Really?
Yeah.
Why Scotland?
That would be where my family's from.
Oh,
she's Scottish.
And I've never been, so I really want to go to the castles.
That'd be awesome.
Excellent. Mm-hmm. We'll skip right over Michelle because she's not going to answer us anyway. She doesn't even want to be a part of this thing. She doesn't care.
No, she has it. She said she has a question for Mace if it's not too late.
Oh,
she
no. Go ahead. Yeah, Michelle, yeah. Go ahead. The question for Mace is it in the chat window?
Yeah, it's in the chat.
Why am I not seeing it?
Mace, did you ever find a video of the first club sex event at the ballroom? And if so, will it ever be released?
No. I don't know where Danae is, the guy that filmed that, and I lost my only copy of that video. I used to put on an event called Club Sex at the same place where I put on Club Tattoos. That's how Club Tattoo came to fruition at the ballroom. But it was like we'd have tattoo shops, we'd have like booths, I'd give away sex toys, everything. It was kind of crazy. It was a crazy event. And Michelle remembers it, and we actually made a short film about it, like a documentary. I wish I had that copy. But you can go online, look up Warsaw, and they're playing it. They're playing live Club Sex, a song at Club Sex on YouTube. Warsaw, W-A-R, SAW Club Sex. The song is Club Sex. YouTube.
I remember Warsaw.
Catch that.
Well, I'm definitely going to look for that video. We're going to find a copy of that video for you.
Dude, off the hook.
Yeah. Rick, what's your idea of an excellent adventure right now?
Oh, boy. Kristen sounds pretty good. I'd like to hang out with him maybe. I think the KUPD answer is hookers and blow.
There you go. There you go. That's the KUPD answer for sure.
Would you split the money down the middle and divide it equally, or would you lean more towards upcharging one of the options there?
We'll discuss that later.
On the yacht.
And then Steven, it's Steven, right?
Yes.
Steven, what about you? What's your excellent adventure?
If everything was back to normal, I would probably go to New York City.
Oh, nice. New York City.
Just like I pictured it.
That's right. Have you ever been to New York City before?
No, I have not.
It's beautiful. It's a lot of fun.
A lot of fun.
Absolutely. Well, guys, I can't tell you how much I thank you for joining us today. All of you, everybody that's on this call right now, really appreciate you hanging with us for a little bit. And of course, the members of Grey Daze, super appreciate you guys hanging with us. The album Amends comes out tomorrow. We're all very excited about it. And congratulations again. I think this is a great thing. I think, Chester is up there somewhere saying, hell yeah, it's finally happening. It's finally happening.
Thank you so much, Larry. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Kill him every day. Thanks, Larry. I love you. It's been a long 20 years of you supporting
yeah.
you. So
nice meeting you, Lester, Julia. I know you, Michelle, Steven, and Rick. Nice meeting all of you. Pleasure.
Thanks, brother.
Great to talk to all of you guys. Congratulations to the band again. And thank you so much. Yeah, we'll see you again soon, and we'll keep everybody that's listening on the radio hearing all the new stuff from Grey Daze.
Love it.
Thanks, Larry. Thanks. Everybody. Thanks, Grey Daze.
You bet. Thanks, guys. Take care. Have a great day.
Bye, Mace. Love you, too.
Bye-bye. Love you, too.